So I don't know if it's just me, but asking the question, what is my passion, or truly finding your passion or pursuing something that you love, was kind of a roller coaster in my life, because I was actually interested in a variety of things and in different seasons in my life. And I was never really sure, like, what would I be great at? But luckily for now, the weight is off my shoulders. So this channel is all about freedom, finance, and purpose. And we're just going to talk about a topic that's a bit more informal, but also kind of important. And that is simplifying finding your passion. So first, think to yourself, have you ever resonated with the following scenarios? Have you been asked the question, what is your passion? And you don't have this perfect, clear-cut answer at that moment, and then you just don't feel good about yourself. Or sometimes you feel frustrated because people, friends, or family around you are actually figuring out what they love to do, pursuing it, and making it a reality in their lives. Or you feel like you've missed the opportunity to pursue your passion because you made a wrong career choice. So I have found myself guilty in most of those scenarios. So let's simplify. There's a difference between passion and purpose. If you look at purpose through Google definition, purpose is why something is created. I believe we are all created for a specific purpose and unique purpose. But in this video, we're gonna dive in the passion topic. Here are some takes on passion from people that I really enjoy listening to or reading their books. First one is Mel Robbins. She says, I believe telling people to find their passion is terrible advice. Passion is another word for energy. What energizes you? Tim Ferriss says, when people suggest you follow your passion or your bliss, I propose that they are in fact referring to the same singular concept, excitement. This brings us full circle. The question you should be asking isn't what do I want or what are my goals, but what would excite me? All right, and the last one is Rick Warren from his book, Purpose Driven Life. God gave you a heart and has placed in you passions, desires, and dreams. To get more passionate, get closer to God. So then life happened and I abided by the following. First, everyone has something that excites them. Stop asking, what is my passion? Such a difficult question, and rather ask, what excites me or what energizes me? And most importantly, understand that finding your passion is a progress and a journey and not a specific set destination. Okay, let's dive into some tips and pointers on simplifying finding your passion. First thing, sometimes we do make wrong decisions, but wrong decisions shouldn't be seen as failure. Every decision you have ever made, whether you feel it was the best decision or the worst decision that you made, those decisions contribute and can lead you to getting to know yourself better and actually discovering what gives you joy, gives you fulfillment, or what doesn't, and what you dislike. Those are all just benefits. And if you look at all the benefits of wrong decisions, you're actually thankful for those decisions that you have made. The next one, stop feeling guilty or discouraged. Discovering your passion shouldn't be a burden. It's an awesome adventure and you should just enjoy the ride and enjoy the journey. Nobody is born with a little label saying, this is Bob and this is your passion. No, you find it by living and discovering more aspects of yourself in every season of your life. And that brings us to the next point. Never disregard the season that you are in. Even if it's a season that you feel like I'm not optimizing my full potential right now, I'm not actually pursuing what I love doing, and you feel frustrated, it's okay. Use that as motivation to be excited about the next season in your life, because seasons do change. Every little life experience, if you allow it to be, can be a tool and can contribute to you getting to know yourself better. Live in that season and embrace it. Use it as motivation to move forward. And always be careful not to miss a great lesson that you can learn. The next point that's a very cool factor is that passion can be developed. We are all born with unique personalities and unique aptitudes, and you're an artistic kind of guy or a mathematical kind of girl. But the good news is that passions can be developed through life. studies show that working hard at something, becoming good at it, getting more confidence, and if you're good at something, you actually enjoy it more, and if you enjoy it more, chances are good that you will become passionate about it or even more passionate about it. And I could definitely resonate with that because, for example, that is what happened in my life. I would never have imagined to be passionate about financial wellness or financial freedom. It was definitely developed over a course of time through practicing some methods, applying it, actually chasing some goals, reaching those goals, and seeing some results and fruit in our lives. And in this way, it got me excited, and it excited me even more actually understanding some concepts of the financial world that I have never understood before, and thus I became passionate about it. Another thing about passion that we can also remember is that passion evolves and can be broken up into many different parts or chapters in our lives. Humans are ever evolving, and you are not necessarily the same person that you were in high school. You don't have the same ambitions or goals compared to when you're a young, ambitious career chaser. Or when you have children, then you might be a seriously family-oriented person. So goals, ambitions, values, what you value as important, and passions change over your life. So just be comfortable with that. Like, oh, I always wanted to be this and now I never did that. That's okay. If you have progressed as a person and you have changed, your passions can change as well. Also, passions can be broken up into different parts. It can be multiple. For example, you can be really passionate about entrepreneurship or gardening or community service or sports, and it doesn't necessarily have to be your job what you're passionate about. A book that I read by Bob Goff, where he mentions that his job is not really his passion, it's just something that he does to generate income to do the things that he loves. He's doing great things in life. So if you have a job that generates the income for you and you have a lot of freedom and free time to do the things that you are passionate about or to exercise the things that you love to do, that's great. But if you do find yourself in a space where you're not passionate about your job, it does generate an income for you, but you don't really feel like you have time or you're exhausted to practice the things that gives you joy or that you're passionate about, no worries. I really recommend reading the book from Tim Ferriss, The 4-Hour Workweek, where he breaks down how can you lower your time you spend at a job and be more effective in your job to actually have more time on your hands available to do the things that you love doing in life, or to have time to actually discover what you love doing. An absolute crucial thing in discovering or simplifying your passion is implement curiosity and experimenting as super tools in your life. Albert Einstein said that, "I have no special talent, I am just passionately curious." Think back in your life where you can remember an idea or a concept or something that excited you and you thought like, wow, that would be kind of cool, or I think I would enjoy this. But then you like automatically jumped into a gear where you thought that it's just not realistic, it's not really practical, how will I get there? I didn't do this, I can't do this. And you just don't give yourself any platform or opportunity or a possibility for you to actually pursue it and make a reality in your life. So never, ever, ever suppress curiosity or something that excited you at a certain point in your life. Don't ever hold back to experiment on something new. Even if you fail, that's a great opportunity to learn. You never know, you just might succeed. I've read an article the other day, What is a Curious Explorer? And I really recommend reading the article. She actually gives you some great steps how to use curiosity to do things that you actually love or discovering things that you actually love doing. But she mentioned that journeys taken out of curiosity teach us more than journeys taken out of necessity. I'll link the article in the description box below. But don't be afraid to take on that journey. Get on the path less traveled by doing, making decisions, changing your mind, changing it again. Fail, make mistakes, learn from your mistakes. If you have to sit still and stop running and hustling, and pray a lot and grow in life. And absolutely enjoy this marathon called life, finding your passion. I hope you guys have a great day, a great week, a great life, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.